Assalamualaikum Ustaz. Waalaikumsalam. Saya ingin bertanya, kenapa sulit bagi saya untuk bertobat, terutama saat saya sendirian seringkali saya lupa jika Allah telah tetap mengawasi. Sulit bagi saya untuk menahan syahwat saya, tiap kali itu pula saya bertobat, tapi setelah beberapa hari saya ulangi lagi. Begitu terus, tobat ulangi lagi. Apakah Allah Subhanahu wa taala tidak menerima tobat saya hingga saya tetap mengulanginya lagi? Saya mohon doanya Ustaz agar Allah mengampuni saya dan memberikan jalan untuk saya agar bisa berhenti bermaksiat, dan mohon bimbingannya Ustaz bagaimana agar saya kuat menahan godaan ini. Jazakallah khairan. Assalamualaikum. Ya, wa iyakum. Terima kasih, jazakallah khair. Sekali lagi yang bertanya ini indikasi yang bertanya punya iman, hadirin. Dan yang kedua, menghadirkan perasaan agar Allah tetap mengawasi memang paling susah. Ini bukan kendala yang dialami oleh penanya saja, ini semua kita. Karena memiliki perasaan Allah mengawasi kita itu puncak, itu ihsan. Ihsan itu anta'budallah ka'annaka tarah fa'illam takun tarah fa'innahu yarak. Ihsan itu engkau beribadah kepada Allah seakan-akan engkau melihat Allah. Dan kalau engkau gak bisa sampai titik seperti itu, maka yakinlah Allah melihat anda, Allah mengawasi anda. Itu ihsan. Ihsan itu setelah melewati fase Islam, fase iman. Ini fase tertinggi.
And the cycle of even good people, you know, they're praying, they're reciting Quran, they're even doing umrah, ibadat, but at the same time they can't get away from certain evil practices in their alone time. There are two parts of this problem. One of those parts is spiritual and the other part is psychological. And we have to address both of those parts. Let me start with the psychological, only because most of the time when we have these discussions, we don't address the psychological side, we only address the spiritual side. So I'll try to address the psychological side of this a little bit. You have to understand that in psychology there are triggers. In other words, there are certain situations that make your mind, they certain release certain chemicals in your brain, and they make you want to do some things in certain settings. They are triggers. So for example, for a young man, I'll give a crude example. A young man is watching an action movie, and he's watching the movie and he sees a beautiful woman. And as soon as he sees that one scene, his mind gets triggered. And he pauses the movie and watches something far worse. And he gets into the habit of doing that. It wasn't the movie itself, it was just that one thing that triggered it. Or for some people, when they go back into their apartment or in their room, when they're alone by themselves, bad things happen. When they're by themselves. And when they're at the masjid, obviously it doesn't happen. When they're with their friends, it doesn't happen. When they're on their own, it happens. So the first bit of advice for everyone here and myself is you have to identify, when does the sin happen? When I'm by myself. Where am I when it happens? What times does it happen? And if you can identify the problem times and the problem places and the problem situations, you have to try to change those situations. If you're a young man and you have a problem with, you know, the kinds of things that are available on the internet and you're looking at those kinds of things, for example, put your laptop, put your mobile device, put it in the kitchen. So that your mother's walking by, your dad's walking by, and the mobile device, don't put it in your room. And parents, put that stuff in a visible place in the house. These screens are destroying our kids. Seriously.
Semua merasakan hal yang sama. Semua jungkir balik. Semua tobat tergelincir. Makanya kan Nabi SAW bersabda dalam hadis Tirmidzi, kullu bani Adam khata. Setiap anak Adam banyak melakukan kesalahan. Banyak, bukan satu dua tergelincirnya. Wa khairul khata'ina tawwabun. Dan yang terbaik dari mereka yang paling banyak bertaubat. Jadi tobat bukan sekali, tawabun, paling banyak bertaubat. Mistaubat lagi. Intinya perbanyak tobat.
It is normal for a human being to make tawbah to Allah and then go back and do the sin again, because we are khata'un. The Rasul of Allah SAW described us not as khati'un but khata'un. Kullu bani Adam khata'un. And khata' is a sighatul mubalagha. It's called the hyperbolized state. What that means in simple English is the one who repeats mistakes over and over and over again. Like a khabbaz makes bread over and over again. You know, a khata' makes mistakes over and over again. So that will happen. It's inevitable that some sin will occur over and over again. However, if in the back of your mind, the moment you made tawbah, you are already thinking about 3 weeks from now, I'm going to be doing this again anyway. If you're thinking that in the back of your head, then laysat at-tawbah lil-ladhina ya'maluna sayyi'at. Tawbah is not for people who continually do evil deeds. They've already accepted it. Allah says, وَلَمْ يُصِرُّوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلُوا. They don't insist on what they did. In other words, you have to make a serious, verbalized, conscious commitment. This has to stop. Not that one time you cry and you turn to Allah, I'm so sorry, I can't believe I did this, and you don't do it, you know. You have to figure out a way to get away from this entirely, a serious commitment to yourself. And if you can't do it on your own, seek the help of friends. Seek the help of people you trust. I know it's embarrassing sometimes, but we all need counsel and help sometimes. And when you realize that it's been going on for years and you haven't been able to get out of it, it is time to seek someone else's help. Which is why in the Ummah today, psychological and spiritual counseling is so important. So many young people are in need of counseling, and families are in need of counseling. That is one of the greatest priorities of this Ummah, because that will be a vehicle by which peace will be delivered to people.
Saran saya buat diri saya dan kita semua adalah sabda Nabi, wa'atbi'is sayyi'atal hasanata tamhuha. Ikutilah perbuatan buruk dengan perbuatan baik, niscaya perbuatan baik itu akan menghapus dosa perbuatan buruk. Jadi begitu miss, langsung buat baik, langsung infak, langsung sedekah, langsung perbanyak salat sunnah mutlak, langsung jaga rawatibnya, langsung kalau bisa segera sholat di masjid yang biasanya mepet sebelum qomat gitu. Jadi segera pekan ini misalnya lebih aktif lagi ngaji, weekend ini isi dengan kajian terus diamalkan, kesilaturahim, terus misalnya ingat kematian, ziarah kubur agar ingat mati. Jadi itu hal yang perlu kita contohkan. Wallahu ta'ala bisawab.